blooms and then they bloom. Glasses of grey drunkenness to melt with her in the slime of each embrace. Here in the hollow garden, she comes up to live life twice, to clasp memories in the rotting palms without breathing. On the edge of the pit, the wind troubles her flesh. You almost see the fallen body. It floods and takes heart again, is drawn near and sinks in the mouth. The end of his breathing.
Many, and they were approaching me. Half songs in another tongue they would speak. I was not listening. The ground was giving way in the cellars. Was throwing me, and I was searching among where I heard about the your face. The voice that invites me under these covers. Hides me from the god that I adjure. Do not torture me. And I was running up and down, lost. He will find us again. His voice, perhaps, I hear when I sit for a while. And the moment of sleep. And I calm down now. Down near. No shadow here. I cannot see in the dark. The hand cools between these cuts. And then comes above something like light, more than light.
It poured from the fresh clots in his chest, from his mouth, bitter saliva. Nor could they see what was happening outside. The door had closed. They were only hearing water scouring the earth, or the blood it had nurtured, rising, swallowing, screams of the drowned. And they embraced as they could. You would think for a moment they became one body. He knew then the life of the dead. They were seeing already the world they set out to find. Faith would seal now their lips. What was burnt today will stand forever, one day. They seized the kiss from dissolving jaws. He took the iron bar from under the ashes, twisted a rag around it, sewed it in a hole in the wood. Smoke and tears were then blinding them. Their bones were glowing purple under the skin.
Thank you.